C++ Date and Time. The C++ standard library does not provide a proper data type, and C++ inherits the struct and functions for date and time manipulation from C. If you go for other high level languages, you can find there are some data types which are of the type time or date, but in case of C or in case of C++, there is no such data types are available. So we are inheriting those features of C in our C++ to do some manipulations regarding date and time. To access date and time related functions and structures, you would need to include CTime, that is the respective header file, in your C++ program. There are four time related types are there. One is clock_t, time_t, size_t, and tm. So the types clock_t, size_t, and time_t are capable of representing the system time and date as some sorts of integer. So here we are going to discuss detailing about the structure tm. So if you go for the structure tm declaration into details, you'll be finding all these internal variables have got defined of the type int. So the first one, let me go for one by one. The first one is tm_acc. So seconds of minutes from 0 to 61. It is not 0 to 59. It is from 0 to 61 because sometimes we require some leap seconds in some systems. So int tm_min, minutes of hour from 0 to 59, it is quite logical. So int tm_hour, hours of the day from 0 to 23. Int tm_mday, that is the day of the month from 1 to 31. tm_mon, the month of the year C. tm_year, year since 1900, that is very important. Here we are doing this calculation of this year from 1900. tm_wday, days since Sunday. So it will be ranging from 0 to 6 here. So tm_yday, days since January 1st, that is it will be ranging from 0 to 365. And then tm_isdst, that is hours of daylight saving time. So these are the different fields that are available of the type int under the predefined structure. The name of the structure is tm. So following are the important functions which we use while working with this date and time in C or in both C++. All these functions are part of the standard C and C++ library, and you can check their detail using references as well. So now here we are going to list some respective functions which will be used for date and time manipulation in our C++ code. Say I'm just considering the first one. The name of the function is time, which is taking this one as input argument, and tim_t will be the output argument type. So this returns the current calendar time of the system in numbers of seconds elapsed since January 1st, 1970. If the system has no time, 1 is returned against that. So in case of second function, we are going to discuss as CTime, and here this is the input argument and this is the output argument, that is the character pointer. So this returns a pointer to a string of the form day, month, year, hour, colon minute, colon seconds, that means year slash n slash 0. So in this way, the C time will be returned, and that is my character pointer type. In this way, we are having another one, that is the local time. Also, we are having the list of other functions which will be used in our programming, and these are the very regular functions for the date and time manipulations in C++ coding. So here we are going to have one sample C++ code for the understanding. So here we are having this one, that is tim_t type of variable, that is my noun, and which is containing time 0, which is getting initialized with time 0. So now character pointer dt, that is c time ampersand now, and then we are having the, so we are going to print this dt here. So we are, the local date and time is, that is the respective day, that is the month, that is the respective date. We are having this respective time, we are having this hour, minute and second accordingly, and also the respective year. So this is the format in which it is getting printed. We are also going to print this TM pointer GMTM. We have defined one variable which is taking this GM time and taking this ampersand now, that is a reference of now, it is taking as input argument and it is getting initialized this one, and later from this ASC time, we are using this one as input argument, getting this DT, and DT is getting printed and the output is coming like this. So in this way, we can do the manipulations of date and time. Please type this program at your end and check what are the outputs are coming and what about the functions we have discussed in the earlier slides. Also, you can use them in your respective program and test how these functions can work. Thanks for watching this video.